if you smell what The Rock is cooking. Yes, indeed. The Rock is the new and proud owner of the XFL. Yes, the great one has now brought into a football franchise that he paid $15 million along with his former, his ex-wife slash business partner, Danny Garcia, and Redbird Firm Group. The people's champion, The Rock, now the new owner of the XFL. The Rock has a history with the XFL, but we'll get to that first thing first. We're joining the conversation using the hashtag Vower here on Connect as we talk about the great one, The Rock, is now the new proud owner of the XFL. How this all came about with this. Saw right there, The Rock, Dwayne Johnson, is now the new owner of the XFL, and he done so with fashion. And now let's hear from comments from the new owner, The Rock, on this monumental milestone.
Got to show you this view. It is spectacular of one of my favorite cities in the world, Vancouver, Canada. And look, I've dropped my blood and sweat in this city, wrestled multiple matches in this city, shot big movies in this city. But one thing that a lot of people don't know that I want to share with you guys is when I was 22 years old, I came to this city for the first time. I was playing in the Canadian Football League, playing my first pro football game. I was playing for the Calgary Stampeders. We were playing the BC Lions. I was so excited. 2 days later, I got cut. So dream shattered, sent home with $7 in my pocket. I was like, wait, no, I got to play in the NFL eventually. Those are my big goals. That's my dream. You realize that playing in the NFL was the best thing that never happened because it got me here. So my point is, look, you're going to get your ass kicked. We're going to get the shit kicked out of us. You got to get up. You got to have faith that the one thing you wanted to happen oftentimes is the best thing that never happened. So have faith and just keep that in mind and keep plugging away.
And so right there, The Rock, beyond grateful that he's on the XFL. The Rock has a lot of ventures, a lot in the tequila industry, a lot in fitness, the ATL fitness thing he's doing. And now he's doing a new venture with the XFL. The Rock and his $7 production, as well as the Titan Games. So The Rock is a really busy man, this type. And hey, The Rock can afford it because he's an action star and a movie star as well. So let's hear what you people had to say about The Rock buying his new franchise of the XFL with this.
In some amazing breaking news, Dwayne The Rock Johnson has purchased the remnants of the XFL from Vince McMahon. And this is amazing. This is awesome because Dwayne Johnson, because he has become, if not one of the biggest action movie star in the world. His box office are absolutely amazing. Global influencer, amazing entertainer. And I actually think that Dwayne Johnson, just because of name recognition alone, actually outweighs WWE, outweighs Vince McMahon, outweighs all that stuff. So I think that The Rock will bring something great to XFL 3 when they relaunch. And also, let's not forget, XFL 2 was working until the Rona came in and shut everything out. Like, the level of football was actually picking up. The Houston Roughnecks were actually doing some pretty damn good things. But then, COVID shut down. Like, the first XFL didn't work out because there was no internet and you couldn't get people to watch TNN. Yeah, it's a little rough. But in the internet age, the XFL was actually working. I do think that there is a market for spring football. Even though the UFL, the AAF obviously didn't work. But with The Rock, as well as it sounds like he's got some pretty heavy hitter venture capitalist partners involved, this could work. This actually could be something pretty damn awesome. But I will only accept this league if The Rock suits up for at least one game. Go back. That's just a U being the U, baby. A Rock, full gear, just getting after. What move is that? It was like Gridiron Gang that he actually got. Doesn't matter. But I mean, this is big because Rock certainly knows how to brand, certainly knows how to market himself, absolutely slays it on social media. I'm sure he'll assemble this amazing team. So this could actually be something. And overall, like, the paltry $15 million, you're basically just buying some of the equipment as well as the naming rights. I mean, that's pretty damn cheap. So I think that The Rock could actually flip this investment into something really big because, like I said, I think there is that appetite for spring football. I think that there is this need for a developmental feeder league to the NFL so you can develop and showcase some of these lower tier talents and that actually could develop into something worthwhile in the National Football League. But hell, maybe the XFL will just take off. Maybe they will bring just an exciting newer brand of football. I mean, the NFL is the no fun league. Yeah, well, they're sort of changing that for now. But full-on spectacle, because some of the great things that worked about the first XFL, the spectacle, the showcase, the whole, no-holds-bar attitude, that definitely got sanded away. Like, the rougher edges completely got taken off XFL 2. It got a lot more corporate, a lot more, okay, this is just basically NFL football, but with worse players and worse coaches. I mean, that's all it was. So if they do bring a little bit of that pizzazz, a little bit of that showmanship back from the first XFL, took some of the things that they learned that actually worked with the second XFL, notably social media marketing, as well as some of the new rule implementations, I think this could work. So in 2022, 2023, whenever their first season is going to be, I'll be there because I do think that Dwayne The Rock Johnson and his partners could actually turn this into something phenomenal. But we'll see. What are your thoughts? Let us know in the comment section. You know what to do. Football.
$15 million is the investment The Rock and another group have bought the XFL. Chris, is that a good thing or a bad thing?
I think it's a really good thing. I think it was
we're good.
A league, and I think it would have had a lot of success if not for the pandemic. So you have a brand name in The Rock. $15 million is almost nothing to buy a sports league. Let's say 10 years from now, this thing really does evolve to become kind of the middle tier between college football and the NFL. And I could see it being worth $1 billion at that point. So I think Vince McMahon had put so much money into it and been burned twice now that he was just like, the heck with it, somebody else take it over. But I'd love to see it succeed just so we get these Wolfpack players who aren't quite good enough for the NFL or can't get NFL because of limitations on American players on rosters, have a chance to play professional football after they're done with the Wolfpack and maybe use that as a springboard to get up to the NFL, kind of like a guy like James Butler who was having a great Houston Roughnecks before that season was shut down.
So I know you guys kind of hit this on us before about talking about who's the most popular athlete to follow on social media, and if you can remind everybody out there for off mic, who is that person?
Tom Brady, baby. I said my top follower in terms of his content. Tom Brady. Go watch my TikTok. When you jumped into my question,
I was going to say, who is that number one athlete that you just love to follow?
I knew where you were going with this.
I got to say, my still favorite is James Harrison. Even though he betrayed us and left for your damn Cincinnati Bengals and then went to the Patriots, I still think that guy's workout regimen is something I will never tackle. And so it feels good on the body.
My favorite non-sport one is The Rock, since we now determined that WWE is not a sport.
I played college football. It counts.
Does it count? It counts. He could have played college football if he wanted to.
Carl Weathers did for a minute, and then he decided to get into acting.
Yeah,
I count it.
Yeah. All right, okay. Good. Well, you heard it first.
You know, I look at it from both perspectives. I mean, first, as you said, as a free agent, you know, whether it's even making the first team or not, you know, we talk about it all the time that every time you get the chance to get on the field, you're building your resume, that everybody is looking, every team across the league is looking at guys when they get a chance to be on the football field, whether you're making the roster of the team you're actually on or not. And so those are things that are so important to build your resume and say, hey, I played, you can see it. You know, here's what I'm capable of doing at this level. And so that is disappointing. You know, you're cutting the rosters back by, you know, 10 people. So many guys aren't going to get an opportunity. And I even tell people when I look back to my journey, the one blessing was even outside the NFL, there were opportunities to play. You know, it was arena football and NFL Europe. And so at least I had opportunities to play when I wasn't on an NFL roster. Those guys don't even have that now.
Hey there, Russell fans. How's it going? So I just read this thing that said The Rock, well, Chad just shared it too, that The Rock purchased the XFL out of bankruptcy. If anybody can turn something around, it's The Rock. Former football player. I think he played in Gridiron Gang, which is a great movie. Vince McMahon has no idea what he's doing. This is twice he tried to bring the XFL back, and it's flushed on the toilet. So with that being said, you know, it's awesome. The Rock's got XFL. We'll see what they can do with it. And also too, it's really fun to be a wrestling fan these days. There's a wide scope of feds out there that just keeps us all interested. With all the negativity in the world, we're going to focus on the positive stuff. And WWE, we know that it's not the same as it was. Nothing's ever the same as it was. But, you know, you got Raw, SmackDown, you got NXT, you got Ring of Honor, you got Impact, you got New Japan Pro Wrestling, you got AEW. Which AEW just had purchased Zack Ryder to a contract. Pretty cool to see him, see Arn Anderson back in the ring doing some stuff. That's pretty sweet. I love the fact that the legends are actually managing. They took my advice, what I said last year, and what I've been saying for a while, that managers, legends need to stop coming back in the ring and trying to have one more run. That I love the fact they're scouting talent. And I know Taz has Brian Cage, which has the FTW belt. You got Arn Anderson with Cody Rhodes, who is the TNT TV champion. Then you got Jon Moxley as the AEW world champion. You've got Luke Harper, who now is Brody Lee, who is doing the whole Dark Order, which is sweet. And then you got Tully Blanchard managing Shawn Spears, which I watched AEW Dark matches on YouTube. And I've seen Tully Blanchard in the audience scouting some talent. So it's pretty cool kind of building a stable. You know, you've got Arn Anderson, you got Tully Blanchard over there at AEW. You can get Ric Flair, Charlotte Flair, Tessa Blanchard over there. You have three out of four horsemen. You can redo the four horsemen in the 2020 times. And, you know, even in the 80s, when Ole Anderson left and they brought Lex Luger in, they brought Sid Vicious or Sid Justice or Psycho Sid, whatever you want to call him, they brought Sting in. Every era of the horsemen felt different. Even with a new member, it just felt different. So it would feel right at home to have in 2020, except this time you have Arn Anderson and Tully Blanchard being the mouthpieces like James J. Dillon back in the day. And you just have them like scout like two girls and two guys. Sean Spears, Cody Rhodes, Tessa Blanchard, and Charlotte Flair. There's your four horsemen. You know, it is 2020 now. People are identifying as a lobster, so you can pretty much, you know, become what you think you are, but you know you're not. So it is what it is. I love to see the four horsemen back. Jim Ross is kind of having some kind of situation where AEW is not using a tag rope, and the corner is going to be a rope as far as the tag guy can go to reach out to get a tag. Not many people realize the tag ropes. I did a long time ago. I wonder what it was for. And it's not there just for show. It's there for the guy to reach to the very end of the rope, and he can that far as he can stretch for a tag. So it's pretty cut and dry. And they're not. Jim Ross says they need one. They need to start listing more or whatnot. So there's a lot of stuff going on with JR right now at AEW. I think they need to give him a higher role. He may have a higher role already, but you know, it's. I love JR. Love Tony Schiavone. Love Bobby the Brain Heenan. Rest in peace. One of my favorite managers of all time, Bobby the Brain. Great heel. Miss Gorilla Monsoon. So yeah. So I mean, it's a great day. It's a great, great time these days in 2020. Even with all the turd in the punch bowl with COVID-19 out there this year, you know, I went to a car show the other day down at the river, and it was an awesome car show. Played the national anthem. Everybody stood for the national anthem. Nobody did that kneeling crap. So, honestly, I think down here, if you kneel, I think they knock your block off, just being serious. But also, it's not really just people kneeling because they're scared to kneel. It's because they know what's right. And no matter what your protest, no matter what you're going against, coming against, there's no reason to turn your back to kneel on that American flag and the national anthem. That's spitting in the face of America, past and present. I don't care what anybody's got to say about that. That's just how I feel. That's the patriot me. I love the red, white, and blue. So, guys, Brock Lesnar not returning. I seen a thing with Roman Reigns. He's supporting blood cancer and the COVID-19 victims. I don't know if he's feeling well. I don't know the reason why he left WWE. But all I do know is that I really want him back at WWE. I really thought once he goes away, take a break, I really miss him at WWE. And a lot of people don't like Roman, and that's fine. Everybody don't have to like anybody, the same people. But, I mean, I think honestly, just shoving him in everybody's faces was a little bit too much. But Vince has a habit of doing that. Hulk Hogan. Nothing bad about Stone Cold, though, because I love when he shoved Stone Cold in our faces. That was awesome. But I have no problem with Roman Reigns. He ain't like a Brock Lesnar, where every time is always a championship match and stuff, so... I mean, he had a match with Undertaker with no title, so. I think like two men defeat Undertaker at WrestleMania. It was Brock Lesnar the first and Roman Reigns the second. But Taker fishing out his retirement. So there's a lot of things going on, guys, in 2020 that I'm really excited about. Some more than others, but, you know, there's a new United States championship belt. There's a new Intercontinental championship belt. MVP is the new United States champion. And then you have... AJ Styles just retained his the Intercontinental Champion. So the new United States Championship kind of reminds me of the old NWA Television Championship. But anyways, Bayley retained her SmackDown Women's Championship against Nikki Cross, and then The Fiend came out and did a claw hold on Alexa Bliss and it went off the air. So what does that mean? You know, she showed up at Extreme Rules with the veil, you know, to help you know, Bray Wyatt with the Braun Strowman. But anyways, guys, it's a great time to be a fan, so I'll catch you later. And you all have a good day, and God bless. Take care, and you all stay safe out there. Peace.
But that happened after the match was over.
Get this asshole out of here.
Don't you dare do this to me! I beg this!
So I know you guys kind of hit this on us before about talking about who's the most popular athlete to follow on social media. And if you can remind everybody out there for off mic, who is that person?
Tom Brady, baby.
Is it Tom Brady?
Go follow Cristiano Ronaldo. Said like my top follower in terms of, I love his content. Tom Brady.
Go watch him on TikTok. When you jumped into my question, I was going to say, who is that number one athlete that you just love to follow?
I knew where you were going with this.
I got to say, my still favorite is James Harrison. Even though he betrayed us and left for your damn Cincinnati Bengals and then went to the Patriots, I still think that guy's workout regimen is something I will never tackle. And so it feels good on the body.
My favorite non-sport one is The Rock, since we now determined that WWE is not a sport.
I played college football. It counts.
Does it count? It counts. He could have played college football if he wanted to.
Carl Weathers did for a minute, and then he decided to get into acting.
Yeah, I count it.
Yep. All right, okay, good. Well, you heard it first.
Dwayne Johnson, The Rock, part of a group bringing back the XFL. He buys it out of bankruptcy for a steal $50 million. Now, when will the XFL start playing again? I've been told it won't be in 2021 with the COVID pandemic going on. More like 2022, and we'll make a rebound.
What is going on, guys? Wow. We got some news today. As you well know, I just put up my What the Wrestling News brief just literally 10 minutes ago, and 10 minutes later we got some more news that I could not wait to share, so I'm sharing that shit now. I don't even care. I'm not waiting to put out another video. We're gonna get to this news right now. The Rock, Mr. Dwayne Johnson himself, has bought the goddamn XFL. Wow. The Rock has brought the XFL for $15 million. Wow. Who would have thought? Who would have thought? So The Rock buys the XFL along with Redbird Capital from Vince McMahon for $15 million after their bankruptcy. So as reported on the BleacherReport.com, so The Rock has partnered with Gary Cardinale, I'm butchering that name, but don't judge me, Redbird of Redbird Capital, to purchase the XFL for $15 million on Monday. Scott Soshik of Sportico broke the terms of the deal, which came just before the league and its assets were set to go up for auction. So they bought it just before they were supposed to have an auction, and Vince McMahon let it go. So Vince McMahon's football league filed for bankruptcy protection earlier this year after the pandemic wiped out the inaugural season of the upstart's return. So basically, COVID wiped it out. The viewership was going down. They had a good number to start. They had about 3.1 million people watching the first, the revamped XFL, which he wanted to bring back 2 years ago. He wanted to capitalize off the 30 for 30 that they did on it. He wanted to capitalize off of the stuff going around with Colin Kaepernick and NFL viewership going down. So he wanted to capitalize off of all of that, revamp it. He sold some shares. I think about $100 million worth of stock he sold from WWE so that he could fund the XFL. And even though the viewership was going down week by week, some games even got under a million viewers, the XFL still, you know, it was holding on still. I wanted the XFL to win. You know, the games were actually good. They were competitive. I saw a couple of games. I was not disappointed at the games that I saw. They were competitive. They were fun. They were fun to watch. So I was pulling for the XFL. But then something happens in the world that no one could expect and no one could predict. And here we are. And next thing you know, you got no revenue coming in, but you got to pay all these players. And, you know, everything needed to go right for it to actually be a success anyway. So he kind of just filed for bankruptcy, let it go, closed the doors, fired everybody, and here we are. So now, as tweeted by Kevin, oh man, I'm butchering people's names today. Kevin Schaefer, Kevin Seifert of ESPN. I'm butchering names. Don't judge me. Confirming that at XFL 2020 has been purchased by a group that includes Dwayne Johnson, a.k.a. The Rock, for $15 million, deal contingent on court approval August 7th. Quote from Dwayne Johnson below, the purchasing firm is Redbird Capital Partners, first reported by at Sportico. So, wow. Wow. It's crazy. What are they going to do with it? I don't even know. So, The Rock's ex-wife and business partner, Danny Garcia, will also be a partner in the revamped XFL. McMahon announced the relaunch of the XFL in January 2018, hoping to capitalize on the market for spring football and the popularity of the 30 for 30 documentary of the original XFL, which also folded after one season. The WWE chairman said he was prepared to invest as much as $500 million in the league and divest some of his shares in wrestling company to make it happen. And here we are. This is crazy. So on more on this, the XFL said it had between $10 million and $15 million in liabilities at the time of its bankruptcy filing. Wow. Wow, this is crazy. This is crazy. So, The Rock comes back. Oh, can you get the hell out of the way? Goddamn cat, always in my stream. So, The Rock comes back. And, you know, I don't know what this means. Because The Rock and Vince McMahon, I'm sure, are very close. The Rock made Vince a lot of money. Vince gave The Rock a lot of opportunity to branch off into Hollywood and do what he had to do and keep things moving. So I don't know what this actually means. Is he going to revamp it and continue the XFL with the pandemic going on around the world? Is he going to stop it and make it into something else? I mean, everything he puts his name on, he pretty much, everything Dwayne Johnson puts his name on, it pretty much is a success. So, I don't know what this means. I don't know what's going to happen. All I know is this is big, big news. Major news. So, in the weeks and days to come, we are going to see what happens. But I am so looking forward to seeing what they do with the XFL moving forward. So, that's all I got for y'all. This is my What the Wrestling News Break. Big news on the XFL. And the acquisition of it by Redbird Capital and Dwayne Johnson. So we'll see what happens with this moving forward. All right, y'all. Be safe out there. Peace.
As you saw right there, a lot of people are happy and love people skeptical about The Rock making this move as a football business owner. And now he's going to have the XFL to compete toe-to-toe with the NFL. And we'll see. The great one can go toe-to-toe with the NFL and build a struggling business like the XFL that was under Mr. McMahon, Vince McMahon's of the head of WWE. And now he can build it up and see if it goes to new heights with him being the new owner of the XFL. We'll keep posted on this because this is monumental if you think about The Rock, now new owner of the XFL. The Rock is a household name. And how can he bring credibility to the XFL? We'll see. I've been your host, Kendrick Dixon, so long. As we talk about The Rock, if you smell what he's cooking, as he's the new owner of the XFL. See you later.